In this tutorial, I will give an overview of Python and how you can use SQL Server or communicate with an SQL Server from Python. Before we start, I have created lots of Python resources that you can use for free. These Python resources are available from my webpage. So I have written different Python textbooks and other Python resources that you find on my webpage. So the contents of this tutorial will be, first I will give an overview of database systems in general, then I will introduce SQL Server, and then I will introduce how you can use SQL Server with Python, then I will provide some basic Python examples, and finally a data logging example where I will log data from a temperature sensor into an SQL Server database. So, what is a database? A database is a structured way to store lots of information, and the information inside the database is stored in different tables. And today, everything is stored in a database today. Here are some basic examples. You have bank account systems, you have information on web pages such as Facebook, Wikipedia, YouTube, etc., and lots of other examples. So all these services and applications store the information into a database system. So basically a database system consists of two parts. You have the database itself, and then you have the database management system. So we communicate with the database using this database management system, and then we use structured query language, or shortened SQL, in order to communicate with the database. So from the database management system we can insert data, retrieve data, or update data, or delete data. And also, instead of using a database management system, we can use in this, as we will learn in this tutorial, we will use the Python programming language in order to communicate with the database. So here you see an overview of some popular database systems today. We have Oracle, MySQL, MariaDB, Sybase, and Microsoft Access, and the one we are going to use in this tutorial, Microsoft SQL Server. But we have hundreds of different database systems today. So then let's start with the SQL Server, or also someone prefer to call it SQL Server. The SQL Server consists of what you call a database engine and a management studio. So if you see this example, we have the SQL Server database, and then we have the SQL Server management studio. And the database engine has no graphical interface, it's just a service that's running in background of your computer, or typically on a server. And then you have the SQL Server Management Studio, which is a graphical tool that you can use to configure and communicate with the database. There exist different versions of SQL Server. In this tutorial we will use the SQL Server Express, which is a free edition that you can download for free on the internet. And the SQL Server Express consists of two parts, or two installation packages. It is the database itself, SQL Server Express, and then we have the SQL Server Management Studio, which is the graphical user interface that you can use to communicate with the database, create databases, create tables, insert, retrieve, and modify data, etc. As mentioned, you can install or download SQL Server Express for free on the internet. If you need help installing the software, you can follow my video, which you find a link to here. In this video I go through how you install this SQL Server Express in detail. Here you see an overview of the SQL Server Management Studio. On the left side you have a list of available databases, and if you click on a specific database you will get a list of available tables, etc., in that specific database. And then here in this window, you can write SQL commands in order to communicate with the database. You can retrieve data, etc. And then you will get the results in this window at the bottom. So basically, as mentioned, we will use this structured query language, which is a database language we use in order to write, read, and update or delete data from the database system. And you can use SQL inside the SQL Server Management Studio, as shown here, or you can use it inside your Python script or your Python application. So here you see a basic example, select all from school. This means that you get all the data from the table called school. Here you see some other examples. Here in this example, you insert some data, insert into student, name, number, school, etc. So this is the name of the table, and these are the name of the columns. And then this is the data you want to insert. Here, select school ID, name from school, retrieve the school ID and the name columns from the school table. Here you see an example of how you can update existing data. So update student set name equals to John Wayne, where student ID equals to 2. So this will update the name to John Wayne, where the student ID equals to 2 in the database. And finally, you can also delete data. So delete from student, where school ID equals to 3. So typically we have four different types of queries. We have insert, select, update, and delete. Or also someone wants to call it CRUD, C for create or insert, R for retrieve or select, and U for update data, and D for delete data. So now we know the basics about the SQL server. So how can we use Python in order to communicate with the SQL server? First, for those who haven't used Python before, Python is a fairly old programming language. It was created in 1991, but during the last 10 years it has become very popular. So today Python has become one of the most popular programming languages. And in this tutorial we will use the Anaconda distribution. If you install Python through the Anaconda distribution, you get the Python itself and many of the most used libraries or packages that you typically need in order to create your Python programs. And part of this Anaconda distribution, you will get the Spider Python editor, which I will use in this tutorial. So then next, when you have Python installed, then we need to find a proper Python driver for SQL Server. And there exist lots of different Python SQL drivers that you can use in Python. I will mention a couple of them, PyODBC and PyMSSQL. Both these drivers are not made by Microsoft, which is the vendor of SQL Server, but they are made by the Python community. But Microsoft places lots of testing and efforts into testing especially this PyODBC driver. And also Microsoft contributes to the open source Python community. And they are using this PyODBC driver. So this is the driver we are going to use in this tutorial. So basically, PyODBC is an open source Python module or package that contains the necessary driver that you can use to access ODBC databases in general, and then especially this SQL Server, which we'll use in this tutorial. You'll find more information about this driver or this package on this web page. And this module is very easy to install, so you just use the pip, and pip install PyODBC, and then you have installed the software. So basically, if you are using the Anaconda distribution, then you can just search for and open the Anaconda prompt, and then inside the Anaconda prompt you just type pip install PyODBC, and then you will install the necessary package. So now we are ready to start creating some basic Python examples. So we will create some Python examples that first we'll create and insert some data, then we will retrieve some data and update data and delete data. And you have to notice that the examples I provide here can be considered as a proof of concept. And the sample code and examples are simplified for clarity and doesn't necessarily represent best practices. So we will start by creating a simple example. So we will open SQL Server Management Studio and create the following table. So I will create a simple table called book. So using SQL syntax, create table book, and then this book table will consist of four columns, namely book ID, title, author, and category. So when I have created the book table, I will also insert some books into that table. So just in this example, I will create three different books. So we have some examples that we can work with when creating some Python examples. So now I am inside my SQL Server Management Studio. So here on the left, we have existing databases. So in order to create a new database, you just right click on databases, new database, and then you type the name of the database and then click OK. So I already created this bookstore database, and then inside this bookstore I will create this book table using this basic SQL script, and I already inserted this table, so you find it here under the bookstore database. You find the book table, and this table has the following columns: book ID, title, author, and category. Then next you can insert some data. So I have, as shown earlier, I will just insert three different books using the insert into book SQL command, and then I insert three books with a title, author, and a category. And then when you have inserted these books, you can type select all from book and click execute, and then you will see the available books that has been inserted into that book table. So now our database and our table and our data should be okay. So now we can start creating our Python examples. So the first thing we need to do is to connect to the database using Python. So here you see a basic example. So we need to import PyODBC. This is the Python package we use in order to communicate with the SQL Server. And then we need to connect to the database using PyODBC.connect. And then we need to specify the driver, which I specify here, and the name of the SQL Server, which you specify here, the name of the database, the username you are using in order to connect to the database, and the password. So here you see a basic example. So this is the recommended driver that you're going to use. Here is my SQL Server database. The name of the database in this case is bookstore. In this case I also use the built-in SA user and a proper password. So using this built-in SA user, or short for system administrator, I'm using it to connect to the database, but in general you should use another user or other username in order to connect to the database, because the SA user is a built-in user that has full access to the database. But you should create your own user that you should use instead of the SA user. But I just use the SA user here for simplicity. But you can easily use the SQL Server Management Studio in order to create another user. So if you want to create your own user in the SQL Server Management Studio, you just go to Security and Logins, and then right click, create new login, and then you can create a new login user that you can use instead of this built-in SA user. So next, we have already inserted some data into our SQL Server database using the SQL Server Management Studio. We inserted three different books. So now let's see how we can use Python in order to retrieve that data. So let's see a basic example. So here, we use this import PyODBC. Then we specify the login information, the driver, server, the database, the username, and the password. And then we connect to the database. And then we just use cursor equals to connection, which we have created here, dot cursor. And then we use a for loop in order to loop through all the records inside the database. And here we specify the necessary SQL query. So select book ID, title, author, and category from book. And then you can print the book ID, title, author, and category to the screen. And then hopefully we will get three records, which was the three books we created using the SQL Server Management Studio. So let's create this basic example in Python. So then I have opened my Python editor, the Spider editor. So here you create your script, and then you will see the result or output here in the console window. So then I just start by connecting to the database. So start by importing the package, then specify the driver, my database name, the name of the database. This was the name of the server. I used the SA password, and I've just created a dummy password for that. But of course, as mentioned, you should use another or create and use another login user instead of the SA user. So I just created a dummy password, which I will change later. So this is basically the syntax for connecting to the database. So then I can just click here in order to see if it works. And if you don't get any errors, this will work as expected. So now we was able to connect to the database. Let's see if we are able to retrieve some data. So then we create a cursor. And then use this connection object we have already established here. So connection dot cursor. So we use this in order to retrieve data from the database, and then we need to specify what kind of data we want to retrieve. So then we use typically inside a for loop for row in cursor dot execute, and then inside the execute we create our query. So select book ID, title, author, and category. Category from the book table. That's the SQL query we are going to use. So select book ID, title, author, category from book. And then we need a colon here, since this is a for loop. And then we want just to print these columns to the screen. So print, use this row dot, and the name of this this column, comma, row dot title, comma, row dot author, comma, row dot category, like this. So basically, this is the Python code for connecting to the database, and this code is used to specify the data we are going to retrieve from the database. So let's just run this example. And then you see here in the console window, we was able to retrieve these three records from the database. So 1, 2, 3 is the book ID, this is the title, this is the author, and this is the category. So typically you don't want to put the connection string and the information regarding the username and password here directly in your Python script. So typically you want to put this information in a separate file. So then I just copy this information, create a new Python script like this. Then I can put this into a function. Let's create a function called get connection string or something like that. So now we have created the part where you connect to the database into a separate Python script, and then we have just defined this get connection string method, and then we can save this as, for instance, I just go to my folder here. I just put my files into a temp folder, and then I just call this Python script for database or something. And then I save it, and then I can use this inside my other Python application. So I just delete it from here. So then here, in addition to import PyODBC, I import database, and then I can start creating the connection string here. Connection string equals to database dot get connection string, like this. And then I can use this connect. So here I just connect to the database using the connection string, and the connection string is created in this separate Python module which I have created here. So then I don't need this connect here, I just need the connection string. So here I type connection string like this equals to this, so now I have created the connection string here, and then I can just type return connection string like this. So basically in this database module here, I just create a method called getConnectionString, where I establish the connection string, and then I will use this getConnectionString here in order to retrieve the connection string from this module. So then here in my program, you will not see my username and my password. So then I can just click run here now. So I just need to save it first. I can just save it in the same folder. So I have this temp folder where I have created my database module. Then I can just type SQL server example or something. Like this. Click save and then I can run it. And then you will see I will get the same result, but my connection string is hidden and put into a separate file like this. So basically this is how you use Python and the PyODBC package in order to retrieve data from an SQL server. So in the example so far, we have provided a basic select statement, select book ID, title, author, category from book. With this select statement, you get all the records within that specific table. So what if you just want to get some of the records? In order to do that, you need to introduce the where clause. So then you can put like this, select book ID, title, author, category from book, where, for instance, category equals to data. By doing that, we will get only the books that match this criteria. So let's try that in our Python editor. So here is our Python program, and it gets all the records in that specific table. But if we, at the end here, put a where clause, where, for instance, category equals to data, and then let's run it, then you get only the record that satisfy this criteria. And instead of category, we can have use author, title, etc. So let's say we have just want to have the books for a specific author. So the author is Knut Hamsun. And just click run, and then only the books that is written by Knut Hamsun will pop up in the list here. So that this is how we extend the select statement using this where statement like this. But by writing it like this, it could cause some problems because we can be you can get hacked by so-called SQL injection. So a better approach is to use parameters, and that's because by using parameters we can avoid SQL injection. So this ODBC driver supports parameters by using a question mark as a placeholder in the SQL. So you provide the values for the question marks by passing them after the SQL. And by that, this is a safer than putting the values into the string, because the parameters are then passed to the database separately and protecting against so-called SQL injection attacks. And also it would be more efficient if you execute the same SQL statement repeatedly with different parameters. So let's see how we can do that in our Python program. So here I have extended the example. So instead of typing here where category equals to data or something, I put a question mark here, and then I create a new variable called parameters, and then I just specify the category here instead of putting it here. And then inside my cursor.execute, I have the query, which is here. And then I have a second parameter, which is this list of parameters. So let's create this example in Python. So then we are back in Python and we do some small changes. So instead of putting the query here, I just remove it here and I put it here instead. So then you can just specify query equals to like this. So now we have the query here, and instead of author equals to Knut Hamsun, I just put a question mark like this, and then I here with parameters equals to data. This is the author, so here I can put Knut Hamsun like this, and then in the execute here I put the query variable and the parameters variable like this as an input to this execute method. So let's just run it now. And as you see, you get the same result, but by doing this and separate and put this where clause into a list of parameters like this, then we can avoid this SQL injection. So this is a better approach. So far we have retrieved values using Python by using this select statement. Let's see how we can insert data into the database from our Python application. Let's go back to the Spider editor and make some basic examples. So we are back in Spider environment. I just copied the previous example. I put it into a new script. And then I just save it. And SQL Server insert example or something like this, and I save it, and then I just remove this part and this query. So then this is the same, where I get the connection string, connect to the database and create this cursor. So then we can create a new query, and within this query we are going to insert data. So then I can type something like this: insert into book, and then the name of the columns, title, author, and category, like this. So this is the name of the columns. And then I add values, and then I specify the name of the title. I create a new book called Python for Experts. Then the author could be Elvis. And then finally, we specify the category. This could also be within the data category. And then now we have made an insert statement: insert into book, title, author, and category with a specific value. This is the title, the author, and the category. And then we just add a line, one more line. Cursor dot execute, and an input argument here would be this query like this. And then finally we need just to put cursor dot commit in order to actually store the data here into the database. So let's just run this example. Yeah, a little bit spelling mistake here, commit with two M's of course, and then let's run it once more. And then the script was executed without any errors. Then we can go back to our previous example here. We can just remove these parameters. This script here retrieve all the books within the table called book. So let's just run it. So with this Python script, select book ID, title, author, category from book. And if you run this one, you see we get now 4 books that are stored in the book table. And then as you see here, this 4th book, Python for Experts by Elvis Presley, in the data category. So this script we created here inserted this new book into the database. And when we using this select script, we see that this book has been created into the database. We can also go back to the SQL Server Management Studio and select all from book here and type execute, and then you see this new book has been created into the database. Typically, we also want to add what you call row count. By adding row count, we can see how many new rows that has been inserted or updated into in the database. So then by just dot row count, and then creating a variable here, count equals to cursor dot execute, and the query we have here dot row count, and then after here, after the dot data has been inserted, we can just type a print rows inserted or something like this, and then just string count like this. So by running it now, I can click here, click the run button, but you know, as you see here, we get an error message. This means that this book Python for Experts has been has already been inserted into the database, and since when we was creating the table, I was saying that the title should be unique. This means that you are not able to put 2 equal books into the database. So then let's create a new book, Python for Beginners, and then let's just run it now. And as you see here, rows inserted 1. So this means that there has been inserted one new rows into the database. And then we can go back to this script where we retrieve the data and run it. And then you see we got now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 books into the database. And this new one, Python for Beginners, has been inserted into our database. Also here we can use parameters in order to avoid SQL injection. So then in addition to the query, we just create parameters like this. Oh, sorry, of course it's not in this example, but it's in this example. So here we are inserting a new book, but let's add a list of parameters here as well. So then instead of having the values here, I just remove it here and put it here instead. So then we have Python for Beginners, Elvis Presley, which is the author, and data, which is the category. So here we just use these question marks. So 1, 2, 3 question marks. So the first one is title, this is the author, and the third one is the category. So let's create a new book now, Python for Dummies by Elvis Presley, and also this in the data category. So then, in addition to the query here, we also add the parameters argument like this. And let's run it. And you see one number of rows inserted was 1. So now we have using this question mark instead, and then we type this list of parameters here. And let's just run this in order to see if the data has been inserted. And as you see, now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 books into our database, and this new one, Python for Dummies by Elvis Presley, within the data category. So basically, this is how you insert data into the database from Python. And then we added this row count, and we also added parameters in order to avoid SQL injection. Next, let's see how we can modify existing data in the database using Python. So then we need to use this update statement in the SQL language. So here you see a basic example. This piece of code is the same as in the previous examples, but now the query will be update book set title Python tutorial where book ID equals to 5. So now we are going to update the title for a specific book where the book ID equals to 5. And then you just use this cursor.execute query and cursor.commit. So this is a basic update statement. Also here we can add row count in order to see how many rows that has been updated. And also here we can use parameters. So instead of typing here where book ID equals to 5, we can type where book ID equals to question mark. And then we can add these parameters. And I just set book ID equals to 5, and then parameters equals to book ID. And then I just add these parameters as an argument to this execute method. So let's try this example in Python. So we are back in the spider. I just create a new script. I just copy the entire code from the PowerPoint in order to save some time. Like this, I just save it. And then SQL Server update example or something. And then, so let's start with this where we have select all the books. So now we have, this is the book ID, 1, 2, 3, 16. So assume we want to change this one, Python for Experts, where book ID equals to 16. So then update book set title Python tutorial where book ID equals to 16, like this. And then let's just run it. And then as you see, also here I have this row count, and then print rows updated. And so one row has been updated. So let's see now. I run this select script once more. And as you see, for book ID number 16, then the title has been changed to Python tutorial, like this. So basically, this is how we update existing data in the database using this update statement. So now we have inserted data, we have retrieved data, and we have modified or updated existing data. So finally, then we should show how we can delete data in our SQL Server database using Python. So the code is almost identical. We have this import, we have the connection string, we connect to the database, we establish this cursor, and then now the query will be like this, delete from book where book ID equals to, for instance, 10. By running this statement, we will delete the record that has the book ID equals to 10. And then we just use cursor.execute and the query. And also here we can use or include this row count as in previous examples, and we can also use delete with parameters. So instead of book ID equals to 12 or something, we use a question mark, and then we can set parameters equals to 12. That when we are running the query, then this question mark will be replaced by 12. So let's also run this example using our Spider editor. So now we are back in Spider. I just create a new script. I just copy it, the code from the PowerPoint in order to save some time. Then I save it as SQL Server delete example, like this. And then when we are running this script where we select all the records from the database, we see that we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 books in the database, and the book ID 1, 2, 3, 16, 18, and 19. Assume we want to delete this one, book ID number 16. Then here we just specify 16. So delete from book where book ID question mark, and then parameters 16. And then in the cursor.execute we have the query and the parameters like this. Can also do like this. Book ID equals to 16, and then we can put the parameters like this. So let's run this example. I click on the run button and rows deleted 1. So let's just double check. Go back to the Python script where we select all the data, and let's run it. And hopefully now this number 16 should be deleted. And as you see, instead of 6 books in the database, we have now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the book with book ID 16 that was between here has been deleted. So basically, this is how we delete data from a specific table using this delete command in the SQL language. So far I have shown some basic examples where we insert data, select data, modify data, and delete data in an SQL Server database from Python. But let's finally create some more realistic example. So I will provide a data logging example. So with this example we can log data from a DAC device or similar, but just to provide a basic example, I will create some simple random temperature values from an imaginary temperature sensor. So I will use the built-in random feature in Python in order to generate some random temperature data. So I will show you a script where we insert these random temperature data into the SQL Server database, and then afterwards I will create a new script where we read those values from the database and plot them. So first we need to create a new database. So I create a new database in SQL Server using the SQL Server Management Studio. I call the database just logging system. You can of course call it whatever you like. And then I insert a new table. I just call the new table measurement data, consists of these four basic columns. Measurement ID, which is just a primary key using this identity. So it's just it is just created automatically with a running number 1, 2, 3, etc. And then we have a sensor name, a measurement value, and a date time for the measurement. So that's basically what we need in order to create a basic logging system. So So we are back in the SQL Server Management Studio, and here, in order to create a new database, I just right-click on databases and create a new database. I have already created this logging system, and within the logging system, I have created this measurement data table. When I click write this SQL command, select all from measurement data, you see there are no data into this table. So let's see how we can create a basic logging system that adds temperature data into this table. So now I'm back in the Spider Editor. I have already created the example. It's almost identical as many of the previous examples. First we need to connect to the database. Then I have a basic insert statement. Insert into measurement data, sensor name, measurement value, and measurement datetime. And then values is, then I'm using this parameters syntax with question mark. And then the sensor name will be temperature. And then here within a for loop, I just start by generating some random temperature data using this built-in random.randint function. So I need to use this import random here on top. And then using this method, you need to specify a low limit and a upper limit. So I specify that we are going to generate some temperature data between 20 and 25 degrees Celsius. So then we have this measurement value ready. And then we need to find a datetime. So then I just use this built-in function datetime.now. So then I import this library as well. So now we have the sensor name here. We have the measurement value, which is here. And then we have the measurement datetime, which is this final column in our table. And then we can start inserting the data into the database. So then I create this parameters list with sensor name, which is here, measurement value, which is here, and measurement datetime, which is created here. And then cursor.execute and the query, which is here, and the parameters. And then you see the query can be put outside the for loop because this query doesn't change, only the parameter list will be changing, so then the parameter lists are put into the for loop like this. And then I will, in each iteration, I will sleep for number of seconds I put here, so then we can have a sampling time on, for instance, on in this example, I will start with a sampling time on with 2 seconds. And then number of iterations in the for loop could be 10, 20, 100, depending on how long you want to log data. I just specify 10 iterations with a sampling time of 2 seconds. So then the total execution time for this script will then be 20 seconds. So let's just run this example. I click on the run button. And as you see, we also get an error here. Invalid object name, measurement data. So we need to go to our database.python. And now the database is no longer bookstore. But now our database is logging system. So instead of bookstore, we need to put logging system here. Our username password is the same, and the driver and the server is the same. So then I just save this one, and let's run this logging application once more. Yeah, spelling mistake here. So logging system like this. I save it and try once more. And now our application is running, and then we just need to wait 20 seconds, and after 20 seconds our script is finished executed. And then let's see if some data has been inserted into our database. So then I will go back to Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio, select all from measurement data, click execute here, and then you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 records has been created. And then we have here some generated random temperature data between 20 and 25 degrees Celsius. We have the name of the sensor, which is the same. And then we have this measurement ID, which is just a running number. And then we have the measurement datetime. And then you see the change in data here is 2 seconds. So here we have 1344, 1346, 1348, etc. So basically, this is how we create a basic logging system in with Python, where we log, in this case, just some random temperature data into the SQL Server database. And of course, we can change this piece of code with logging from a real temperature sensor. So let's now next create a new script where we retrieve the data from the database and plot it using Python. So then I just copy the code here I have already made. I save it. Plotting example or something. And let's go through the code. So it's the same here. We import the pi of the BC driver. And for plotting, we use the matplot library. And then import the database, since our database connection is stored in this Python module. Then we connect to the database. And here we have the query where we use an a select statement. So select measurement value, measurement datetime from measurement data, where sensor name, question mark. And then we just use this parameters syntax and put sensor name here, which we have here. So the sensor name is temperature. And then I just create 2 empty arrays, one for the time and one for the actual temperature data. And then we create a for loop, row in cursor.execute, and then we have the query and the parameters list. And then we use row.measurementValue to get the measurement value, and then row.measurementDateTime in order to get the datetime. And then I put these values into these arrays, t and data, using dot append like this. And then finally, we use the matplotlib for plotting. So plot.plot t versus data. And then we can add some title, x labels, y labels, grid, etc. So let's just run this example. And as you see here, we got this beautiful plot where we have retrieved the temperature data from the database, and then we're plotting it into this chart like this. So basically, this is how you create a basic logging system, and then finally a basic monitoring system where we plot the temperature data from the database like this. So that's all. That's how you use Python in order to communicate with an SQL Server database. We have learned how we can insert data, retrieve data, modify data, and delete data, and also how we can create a basic data logging application and a monitoring application. If you want to learn more about Python, take a closer look at some of my Python resources, which you find on my webpage. So that's all. So good luck with your Python programming. Thank you.